Chapter 7. In loving memory of Francesco Panza. Welcome back to Mafia 2. I'm Go Burns. We're doing Mafia 2 on the Xbox 360. Hell yeah. Alright. We're in the 50s.
Called in a few favors and arranged for me to get out early. Knocked almost 4 years off my sentence. Now, Joe used to come visit me and, you know, kind of fill me in on what was happening on the outside. But I tell you, as soon as I walked out of that prison gate, it was like a whole new world.
All right, so we are back after a very, very brief hiatus. Because yesterday we had to do episode 2 of Batman Telltale. So, yeah, that's what yesterday was all about. So, Batman. All right, so I am obviously not drunk. I am drinking, but it's tea. And I want to thank you all for your kind words over the past few days. You guys, like I always say, are the best subscribers that I could ever hope to have. And you pretty much proved that point over the past week. But anyways, you know, we all have to deal with loss, but eventually we got to keep going. You know, that's what life's all about. We keep going in loving memory of my dad and loving memory of whoever the guy is that the chapter is named after. So anyways, we are going to keep this going. And I just want to let you know on some inside baseball. Because every now and then I like to do that. You know, kind of like pull up the veil, the curtain. Now, I am technically redoing chapters 7 through 9. Because the night my father died, I kept recording videos. I started recording videos before he died of my Mafia 2 Let's Play. But I kept going and I kept getting drunker and drunker. Trying, I guess, to deal with it last week. And I actually made it all the way up to chapter 9. However, I was still tweaking the audio. Hopefully the audio is better now on my Blue Yeti. And I was getting really, really shit-faced. I mean, most of you noticed that by chapters, 4, 5, and 6. But 7, 8, 9, I was completely blitzed. And so I decided, you know what? I think it's probably for the best that I just restart from chapter 7. So anyways, let us do this, shall we? Getting into chapter 7. Vito is finally out of jail, and, he's in a new lease on life, a chance for a new beginning, which is always a good thing. All right, let's see how our friend's doing. Is this our friend? No, that's not our friend. What floor is this? Does Joe even live here anymore? Oh, we went, a little low there. Oh. Hello, look at that. Nice. Very nice. Okay. I haven't seen a lady in a while. Because I've been in jail. Prison. The big house. The slammer. Is anyone home? Hello? Joe? Where you been, Joe?
Oh. Hey, you break out of jail? Ah, jeez. Good to see you in regular clothes and on the right side of the bars again. Welcome home. Come on in. Come in. Come in.
Man, I tell you, lots changed since I went away.
Yeah, I guess it has. And hey, it ain't much, but I hooked you up with a nice little apartment, just like you
Thanks.
Said. Now I got a surprise for you. We're going out tonight to celebrate, and I'm going to introduce you to somebody.
Yeah, sounds good to me.
You're going
to
need a little cash so you can get things going again. I got a piece for you, too, if you want it. Ah, here. Always comes in handy. So, what do you want to do now that you're a free man?
Hey, what do you think? I want to go back to working with you again.
All right. I was worried they might have turned you straight in there.
I actually met a lot of people and learned a lot when I was on the inside. And a much better idea of how things work.
Good thing, because I wasn't exactly sitting around on my ass while you was in there. Don't worry, though. I'll show you the ropes, like always.
All right, well, what are we waiting for? Let's go.
Jesus, I didn't expect you to be raring to go like this, but what the hell? Come on, let's go see your new place.
All right,
we'll take my car and go meet your new landlord. You do the driving so you can get back into the swing of things. Just hope you didn't forget how to drive while you was in the can.
Hey, what are you worried about? It's like riding a bicycle.
Sure, but when you smack up your bicycle, it don't cost a fortune to fix the friggin' thing.
All right, I get it. You're like an old lady.
Yeah, I sure as hell hope so. And if you ain't noticed, cars are a lot different since you went away. You'll see. Your new place is just down the street, right near the boardwalk. You're gonna love it.
All right, let's go. Off we go, Joe. And, so I've been trying to prevent copyright claims from hitting the channel. So let me look at something real quick. I'll be right back. All right. So, anyways, before I started recording, I turned the radio down. But I guess radio does not mean music that happens to appear in cutscenes, which kind of sucks. So, like, there was one video, I think it was Chapter 2, that got riddled with copyright claims. It was so riddled it took forever for me to have it edited out. Fortunately, like, YouTube can edit out music, but in the end, I guess it kind of fucks up the audio. But anyways, that was a real pain in the ass, but I mean, I just got the fear that I might already be getting some copyright claims for this video, because like the very opening, there's a song in the intro, and let's turn that off.
Have you home. I've done pretty good while you was locked up, but now that you're out, the sky's the limit.
You seen Henry lately?
Nah, not for a few years now. You really felt bad about what happened, you know.
So what you been up to? We couldn't really talk about much when you visited me.
Well, after the shit Clemente and that little asshole Luca tried to pull on us, I got hooked up with the Falcone family and I started working for them.
Really?
Yeah, you'll see tonight. I told you, I got a nice surprise planned for you. But don't bother asking, because I ain't gonna tell you.
Oh, boy.
Don't worry. I've been planning this for weeks.
That's what I'm afraid of.
Oh, Joe, you little planner. Always up to something, aren't you? So, yeah, I hope that I don't get too many copyright claims for this video. I'm counting... My pool right now is 2. So how many copyright claims do you think I'm going to get? 2? 20? But anyways, so... but anyway, for those of you wondering what a copyright claim is, okay, so... music is copyrighted. And most of the time... I try to make sure that I don't have any music in my videos, whether it's Mafia or Grand Theft Auto Online, for example. But every now and then it happens, and you get screwed because it wasn't intentional, but you know YouTube doesn't see
all
it
right,
that way.
Close enough. Park here.
Okay.
Check the place out. It's on the top floor.
All right, hold on.
I already paid the first month's rent for you. And hey, the entrance to your garage is on that side street over there.
Thanks, Joe. I appreciate it.
Hey, and about tonight, we're going to a real classy joint. So buy yourself a nice suit. They won't let you in this place look like an ex-con.
My kind of place.
Yeah, thanks, Joe. Alright, so anyways, it doesn't really matter because once YouTube fixes it, then it's not really a big deal. Except for, you know, some small audio issues. But anyways, let's go check out Vito's new pad, see if it's worth checking out. Hopefully it's, you know, got some nice accommodations. Probably doesn't. But you never know. Alright, is this it? No. Okay, we need to go up again. Damn, we're up here pretty high.
Okay, here we are. I'm sure you'll find it to your liking. I live in a similar apartment myself.
Dude.
As you can see,
pull down your pants a little, son.
Telephone at no extra charge. And here's the bathroom. Clean and modern, with all the hot water you could ever want.
Nice.
And here is the master bedroom. And there is the master's bed. It's comfy, with room enough for 2. Maybe 3. And it doesn't squeak. Always a plus in my book.
Jeez.
I sure hope you like your new apartment, sir. If you have any questions, feel free to ask.
Just one question. When are you leaving?
Now, if you'll pardon me, I have to go and check on another client. Goodbye now.
Yeah, see you.
Yeah, see, I don't really care for sagging, you know, whenever, you know, you wear the pants, like, too low. I don't know why people do that, but, you know, teach their own, man. Teach their own. But, like, sagging and doing that with your pants, like, you know, there's kind of like a middle area, you know. You're supposed to put the pants on the waist, not up here all the way up on your stomach, but all the way down to your bum. I don't know, but I just find both styles to be funny. I don't know, but look at this bed. There's no sheets, no anything. It's just like a 6 little mattresses put together. But I don't know how comfortable that's going to be. I guess it beats, you know, where Vito was staying for the past few years, hopefully. Oh, we got one of them television things. Do we have cable? No cable? Damn. That sucks. All right, so usually, I think there's a Playboy magazine that appears like right here. But I think I've collected it before, so it doesn't reappear if you've already collected it. And, of course, let's see if there's anything delicious in the fridge. Oh, we got some beer. Master beer. And some Swift Cola. And a sandwich. I'm okay right now. Hopefully I'll be better than prison food. Alright, so I think we're pretty much done here. We gotta go buy a suit, though. You're a jerk.
I really hope this guy shows up soon. I've got a lot on my plate today. And the housing market is booming.
Some advice. You know, like, slide them pants down just a little bit. Just a little bit. Doesn't look right on you, pal. Anyways, let's go. You know, you're trying to get somebody advice, they don't listen to you. You know, that's their own problem. You know, I don't claim to be, like, a fashion expert or anything, but geez. Alright, we need to go to a clothing store, and we need a vehicle. Fortunately, we have some rides over here in our garage, and they're all fucked up. Look at this shit. It would cost $271 to repair this car, and all I got is $200. Well, no thanks. $157 to repair this one. Jeez, all my cars are fucked. They're all foobarred. Ah, fuck it. I don't want any of them. Is there any cops nearby? Any cops nearby? We'll grab this one real quick. Hopefully Vito still knows how to pick a lock.
Ah, nope. Damn it.
Okay, now! No. It's been a while, okay? It's prison life, man. Prison. No! Damn it. Shit. Come on. Alright, there we go. I got a new ride. See? What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and so this only works with the radio, okay. When I turned it down the options section before I started. So that kinda sucks. Okay, park it. Alright, now get it out. Now I have it forever. See, that's in a little bit better condition than the other rides I have. So act like, yep, this is my ride. I've had it all along. Would you guys mind moving? I gotta go to the clothing store. Damn it. Get the fuck out of my way. Nope. I just got this car. Leave me alone. Alright, alright. Off we go. And if you happen to see a clothing store, let me know. We'll stop and get some. Is this where we have to go to? Oh, okay. It's, sending me directly to a clothing store. That's very convenient. Very, very convenient. Okay. Stop. Perfect. Okay, here we go. Alright, hello.
If you like what you see, let me know.
I will. I will definitely let you know. Okay, there's some blues, some grays. $60. That's okay. Let's get a black suit. We'll get a black suit. I think I'm good. That's not bad. Not too shabby. Okay. Alright. Thanks. I'm out. Yep. I gotta get to wherever we're going. We gotta go pick up Joe, I guess. It's a nice ride right here. But the Potomac Indian, I think that's the name of this sweet ride. So you guys excited for Mafia 3? We are getting closer and closer to the release. October 7th. That's right, Xbox One, PlayStation 4, and PC. And yes, I'm definitely going to be Let's Playing Mafia 3 as well. FYI. I always get asked that question. I mean, I don't know, I guess because a lot of new subscribers are coming in, a lot of new viewers. And, you know, they're just asking the same question that's been asked over and over again. Because they don't know. It's all good. But to answer your question, yes, I will be Let's Playing Mafia 3. And looking forward to that as well. So, anyways, we're here back at Joe's, and I got a really good deal on this car. 5-finger discount. So we're gonna go back up and see if Joe's ready. What were you two doing? Oh, was there some hanky-panky happening on the bench between you two? I know it was. Oh, look at you acting all innocent. Oh, no, we weren't doing anything over here. whatever. I saw what you two were doing. Yeah. Oh, you know you're gonna go behind the bushes. Okay. Well, I'll leave you two to it then. All right. Fine. You know. Hey. You know. I'd expect the same courtesy. You know. Me and a, you know, nice little lady friend were. you know. Okay. So, anyways, let's go to Joe's. And hopefully he's ready by now. Can't wait to see what the surprise is. Knock, knock, Joe. Let me in. Knock, knock. There we go.
Jeez, I thought you was going to be a no-show. Not bad. Nice material.
Thanks. So, what's the plan for tonight?
You'll find out. A friend of mine's coming to pick us up. I met him when you was on your little vacation. And show him some respect. He's kind of an important guy.
Oh, yeah?
You'll see in a minute. Here he comes.
Hey, Joe.
Hey, Eddie.
Here I
How's
am.
It going?
Not too bad. Not too bad. Oh, this your buddy?
Yeah. This is my pal, Vito. Vito, this here is a good friend of mine, Eddie Scarpa.
Nice to meet you, Eddie.
Same here, Vito. Okay, fellas. I'm dying for a drink. Let's go. Hey, Vito, you want to drive? I had a couple of drinks already. So, you tell him where we're headed, Joey?
Nope. All he knows is that it's a surprise.
he's gonna love it.
I fucking hope so. Unless he got into the, funny business in the can.
Hey, what are you two talking about?
Don't worry about it. You'll see.
Hey, come on. We might as well tell him now.
Hey, you waited this long. We'll tell him in the car.
You see, Eddie, he's got his pants right. See, not too high, not too low. Right there, see? So props to you, Eddie. Good job. That's why Eddie's a man who knows what he's up to. He's got it going on. Yes, he does. Okay. Sweet ride. All right, so let's, hey, it's a Potomac Indian. I got one just like this, except for...
Let's go, Vito.
I got a different paint job on mine.
Head to Oyster Bay.
All right, Oyster Bay. Also known as the Bay of Oysters. Okay, I don't know why I thought that was funny.
What was the one thing you missed the most when you was in a game?
Freedom.
Yeah, well... But
freedom!
Oh, wow. Booze, broads, baseball, everything.
Now you're getting closer.
What are you guys, taking me to a baseball game?
No!
Yay!
We're taking you to the classiest cat house in the city, Vito.
Cat house, huh? Wow.
Whoa, you don't sound too excited, Vito. Come on, don't tell me you don't want to have some fun after all that time.
Hey, don't worry, Vito. These girls are real professionals. If you forgot how to do it, they'll get you back in shape in no time.
We're gonna have a ball. Oh, hey, remind me not to drink too much. There's something I gotta take care of later.
What's more important than pussy and booze?
You know how it is. Sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do. Hey, Vito, come on, step on it, eh?
I don't want to get pulled over, Eddie, you know. I'm just saying. I just got out of jail, and I'd like to keep it that way for a while, maybe the rest of my life.
What do you got?
And so,
the red lights?
Come on, Joe, stop being like that when it comes to red lights. It's okay to break all these other laws, but, oh, let's not break a red light. You know, let's go pop some fools and, you know, steal some jewelry like we did back in the old days. But, nope, we gotta follow the traffic laws. Of course, Sarah was just 5 seconds earlier, you know, commenting on how I didn't want to speed. Well, the difference is I don't get pulled over for running red lights, which is odd. Very, very odd indeed. Okay, we're almost there. And let's see. I'm probably going to edit this part out just because I don't want any more copyright claims than I'm going to get. And I do believe that there is, you know, one of those songs from the era that is along with here. Plus, there's probably some nudity. And, yeah, I'll probably just edit it out just for shits and grins. All right. Now they're shit-faced.
Hey, where the hell is my car? Somebody stole it. Hey, call the fucking cops, man.
You're staring at it, you lush.
Huh? Oh, yeah, good. Hey, where's my keys?
Vito's gonna drive. He's the least fucked up out of all us.
Yeah, next time for us, Joe. More pussy, less booze.
That's a good idea. After last week, I need a lot less booze. Oh, man. I'm still recovering, but anyways. So, obviously I cut that scene out for the cat house because A, music, B, Thaix. And yeah, YouTube is now. They're very, very anal about that shit. Speaking of sex, right? So, yeah, I'm trying not to get any copyright claims.
So, how'd you like the place, Vito? A lot better than playing I just says each in the showers, huh? What the hell's that stink? Eddie, you puke?
What? I wouldn't puke in my own car.
What the hell is that smell then?
Oh, yeah, I'm smelling it too.
Must be Frankie Potts.
What? That asshole puked in your car?
Nah, he's in a trunk.
What?
What?
Hey, it's all your fault, Joey. I told you I had some fucking business to take care of, and you went and got me drunk.
Hey, since when does business to take care of mean dead guy in the trunk?
Hey, whoa. Hey, calm down, Vito. Hey, I expect you. We'll figure something out.
What's to figure? All we gotta do is bury the stiff. I already got his spot picked out, up by the old observatory.
You got a shovel?
Sure, it's in the trunk. And the hole is already dug. All we need to do is chuck him in and cover him up.
All right. Where's this hole?
Okay, a little ways outside of town, there's a path in the forest to a small clearing. That's where the hole is. And hurry it up, will ya? God, I need some fresh air. The stench back here is fucking killing me.
All right. See, right there I had to wait because I didn't want that cop to get onto us. But not only do I am afraid of copyright claims, but also, like, being age-restricted now because YouTube has just gone, like, really, really gung-ho about that whole thing. Like, age restrict this and that.
Oh, stop. Now.
Okay, I'm stopping. Oh, shit. I didn't do it. My bad. Okay, we don't need to look at this shit. I'm gonna look over here. The lovely skyline of Empire Bay. Yep. I don't want to see that shit. No, thanks. Yes, let it all out, Eddie.
Where's this shit coming from? Oh, shit.
Let it out.
Whoa, I don't remember eating calamari.
All right.
Can't hold your booze, can you?
Hey, somebody fucked up your car, Eddie. Wasn't me, I swear. All right, so let's get up to the observatory. And, lay Mr. Frankie Potts to rest. Rest in peace, Potts. Yeah, he kind of smells, doesn't he? Just a little. Ugh. All right, so, anyways, rolling up here. Man, that is a sexy ride. See that? I believe that's the frigate, right? Oh, yeah. I'm definitely getting me one of those. It's, like, probably the best card in the game, I think. Like, what was your favorite Mafia 2 ride? Let me know below in the comment section. Because someone asked me that the other day in the comments. And that was my response. Yep, the frigate is my personal fave. And I'm definitely adding that to the garage sooner rather than later. So, I'm interested to see which of these cars from Mafia 2 did you enjoy riding around Empire Bay in the most. If this isn't your first time watching Mafia 2, and if you actually had the opportunity to play it yourself. And if you haven't, you know, it's a fun game. It's a lot of fun. I love it. And I will say that it still holds up for a game that's 6 years old. Even though there are some things that I really wish that it had. Like, I wish there were more like side quests and activities. But, you know, it is what it is. And it kind of sucks that it's set in an open world, but it's very linear. It's where you have to actually play chapter by chapter. That part, it blows, admittedly. But it was still a great game to play in 2010. Oh, and I remember somebody else making a comment about Mafia 2 being very overrated compared to the first Mafia game. Okay, I loved the very first Mafia game when it came out in 2002 on PC, Mafia: The City of Lost Heaven. The problem is you can't find it anywhere. If you can find it, it's a miracle, and it's also a curse because chances are it's probably for the old consoles. What was it? Xbox and PlayStation 2, I think? I could be wrong about that, but anyways, like, the console version of the first Mafia game was horrible. The PC version was where it was at. So, yeah, hopefully, eventually, 2K will re-release the original Mafia game, because I would have very much liked to have started this with, you know, Mafia City of Lost Heaven, and then let's play that, leading into Mafia 2, and then, of course, leading into Mafia 3 on October 7th. But there is a tie-in between Mafia and Mafia 2 that will, not in this episode, or chapter, but in a future chapter, you'll see. I'm not going to spoil it. But anyways, it does tie into the first Mafia game. And some of you may already know, so we'll just keep our little secret for now on the down low. A little hush hush. Yeah, but I don't know. I don't consider this to be an overrated game, because I still think it's a beautiful game, even though, like I said, it's 6 years old. I mean, is it the greatest game ever? Probably not. But there, I played a way worse games in my time, and I've played this game several times throughout the years. Over the past 6 years, I've played it at least, like I said, a dozen times, and I've enjoyed it every time I've played it. And to me, that says something about a game. Whenever I play a game once and I don't ever play it again, or I try to get through it and I just give up because it's just not interesting to me, that, in my opinion, is not a good game. And that's just my opinion. It doesn't mean it's a bad game. It just was a game I didn't really care for. But this game, it's not the case. I really like Mafia 2. I think for the time, for, you know, 2010, this was a very innovative game. And that's saying something, I think. So I'm very excited about the direction Mafia is going with Mafia 3. And I look forward to seeing how that story plays out. Hopefully it won't suck too much. That was shit-faced.
Rito.
Oh, who yells pain?
Is that a joke?
Uh-oh. Oh,
that's great.
God.
That's just great. Yeah.
God damn it, new shoes. Jesus Christ. Well, fucking Christ almighty! How long this guy been in here, Reddy?
Just a couple days.
You're gonna have to get him out of there, Vito.
That's just great.
I can't handle the smell.
Some fucking welcome home this is.
Yeah. Nice. Whoa. Very nice.
Mother. Hey, here's a hole. Right here. Dump him in.
Oh, jeez. Bye.
Finally done. Okay. Now who's gonna bury him?
What?
Hey, give me a minute to get a hold of myself. Can you just do it? Every time I get a whiff of the guy, makes me have to puke. And Eddie's not gonna be any help here.
Fine, whatever.
Wow.
Hey, fellas.
Believable.
How about a little music, eh?
How about not? No thanks.
You gotta be kidding me. Good night, sweetheart.
Oh, God.
It's time to.
This wasn't supposed to be part of your homecoming party, but it's nice out here, ain't it? I ain't been in the woods for a while.
Yeah, you won't be liking it so damn much after I smack you with this shovel.
That was fun. Alright, so anyways, we laid Mr. Potts to rest. Yeah, it's not a bad place to be buried, I guess. I mean, plus, you know, funeral costs and all, which I had to deal with this past week. Well, I'll see you later, Potts. You know, funeral costs are expensive. Yeah. But anyways, so let's get going. Fuck it. Guys, are y'all in here? Okay, good. We're out of here. Time to head back.
Oh no.
Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you.
Hey, what you doing fuck you. For? What's the matter? You don't like my singing? Nah, Vito. Just for that, I ain't gonna sing no more. You really ruined it, you know?
Oh my god, you guys couldn't carry a tune if it was bolted to your chest.
Okay, so see, that's another one of those events that happens in the game that some of you may not have known about. See, you may not know. Oh, I could just jump out of the car and I don't have to listen to those assholes sing and I don't have to get a copyright claim. Yep. Fuck that shit. Turn this shit off. Alright, I'm probably getting enough copyright claims already, but that's okay. I mean, it's not really that big of a deal. Because it's always something that can be fixed, remedied within an edit. But one thing I hate about it is it does fuck up my audio. But that's life. It's funny because I turn off the radio. And unfortunately, it doesn't matter because certain cutscenes have music in it. Music that's copyrighted. And then there's cutscenes with freaking sex scenes in it. And I can't put that up either. Oh, well. Yeah, it feels different, you know, getting back into this because it was like, you know, several days I didn't play any video games. Several days I was dealing with that other shit going on in my life, you know, which is unfortunately something most of us have to deal with if we live long enough, you know, the loss of others. And yeah, I mean, I feel like it's been a while. It definitely has. And it's interesting actually playing sober. The only thing I'm drinking right now is tea. So I've decided on some new objectives in my life. Some new directions I want to go. Because you never know when it's our time, you know. You never know when your time's going to be up. Some people live to be, you know, 102. My dad lived to be 62. But my mom, she only lived to be 25. So, like right now, my objective... Because I honestly didn't think when I was growing up that I was going to actually live, you know, past the same age my mom was when she passed away back in 82. I thought I was going to die around 25, and yet 10 years later, I'm still here for some reason. So I have a new objective in life, and it's to live to be 63 if I can make it. I'm going to try, but in order to do that, I got to get back in shape. I got to start being healthier, which has been an uphill struggle for me over the past few years, and I need to probably consider cutting back on drinking. I mean, honestly, you know, don't see me as drinking as a positive. You know, usually it's because, you know, I'm dealing with my own pains and issues, and it's just me trying to, I guess, numb that pain. And like, FYI, if you do drink, you know, be responsible, get shit-faced at home, or make sure you have a designated driver, because you don't want to put anyone else in danger because of your own, you know, stupid choices. And you also don't want to get, like, if your country has a DUI or DWI for drinking while intoxicated or under the influence. You definitely don't want that shit either. So, that's just my advice, my two cents for anyone out there. But if you don't drink, well, good for you. You know, don't, there's no reason to start drinking. If you don't really have a knack or taste for it, because, yeah. I mean, I went several years without ever drinking. And then I found out about hard cider, because I never really cared for beer or wine or hard liquor. Ugh. Not really a hard liquor person, but anyways. So, yeah, that's pretty much my beef there. I'm going to try and get my act together so that I can make it to 63, which is about, what is that for me? Let me count that.
Sorry, okay. Vito. Not exactly the best way to end the night, huh? But thanks. I owe you one big time. Leave Eddie's car here so he can get home in the morning.
You're a good man, Vito. I'll settle up with you tomorrow. Hey, you coming in for some drinks?
It's 3 a.m. Shut the hell up!
Hey, shut up, you whore!
Come on!
We'll you had enough, Eddie. Girls, you're going to bed. Come on. I'll call you tomorrow, Vito. Good night.
Good night, guys. Sleep tight. Oh, man. I swear. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed Chapter 7 of Mafia 2. And come back tomorrow. And we'll continue Mafia 2 Let's Play into Chapter 8.